right after the midnight hours when we're looking at landfall, it could be close to a category 2, if not a category 2. Now, it doesn't look very well organized. You can see where the center is, and all the activity really is on the eastern flank, but the radar is even showing it as well. But notice that we've got lightning strikes. That means near the core, it's really trying to develop now and will strengthen overnight and through the day tomorrow. Its current position is about 215 miles from the mouth of the Mississippi. You see the flood watch is already in effect because as this spins, it's going to put on the brakes. And that's what we just do not want to see. We don't want to see an approaching hurricane start to slow down. And like, for instance, tomorrow at 8 p.m., it's just offshore the mouth of the Mississippi. But by Tuesday morning at 8 a.m., it's only 40 miles inland. This could drop a catastrophic rainfall. We could be measuring by the foot. In fact, you can see where the hurricane warnings are in effect, all in red. Parishes, Louisiana, southern Mississippi. There will be heavy amounts of rain, Mississippi and Alabama as well. Winds are going to be strong enough. We could have power outages widespread. Of course, the worst is that right there, Plaquemines, Ferris, St. Bernard. Really, I think New Orleans is on the wrong side of the storm, and that's just unfortunate. Hopefully, we can get a little shift in this change, but you got winds at 110 miles per hour. You could still have damage in other areas. I mean, Lake Charles, there's still over 50,000 without power there, so a lot of debris could get picked up by these strong winds. Notice the angle of approach, and that's kind of frightening too, Anna, as we watch all of this water, the surge, gets pushed into every little inlet. And you can see the difference from Hurricane Katrina. So Katrina came up almost due south, or from the south. This is more of a glance that's going to throw all of this heavy surge, 7 to 11 feet, into these parishes of Louisiana. So take this seriously. It's spun up out of nowhere, I know that. But you only have tonight and tomorrow, because the rain's really going to start to pick up, I think, tomorrow. So make sure everything is done ahead of time.
Look out for Sally. Tom Sater, thank you so much for that update and very important information. In the meantime, that's what's happening on the Gulf Coast. The West Coast is also in the throes of a major disaster. We'll take you live to California, where wildfires have now burned an area equal to more than 4 Rhode Islands. That's straight ahead, live in the CNN newsroom. Plus, a huge reward is now being offered for any information leading to the suspect who ambushed 2 deputies in Compton overnight. The latest on the investigation next.
The NFL is back, and every game can be heard on SiriusXM. It was an offseason filled with questions and changes.
The NFL draft will be held virtually.
Brady is signing with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
The Raiders moved to Las Vegas.
The one thing that didn't change, the NFL is kicking off their regular season as scheduled.
Prescott and Godfrey twist, Strafe to the left side of the end zone. Touchdown!
Listen tonight at 8 Eastern as Dak Prescott and the Cowboys head to L.A. to try to spoil the Rams' home opener on NFL Radio, Channel 88.
Former Vice President Joe Biden. We have to let